Welcome to Netpresenter's message server tutorial video. This video will help you create and manage your content in Netpresenter Message Server 16. First, access the message server via your favorite browser. Fill in your username and password to log in. You will be greeted with all the active and inactive messages in the message overview. Before you start working though, be sure to check that you're working in the correct site. To change it, click the Change Site button and a drop-down menu will appear to select your desired site. To create a new message, click the New Message button. In the Content field, you can fill in your title and body text. On the right side, you will see a live preview of your message. If you want a different layout, you can change the current template by clicking on the Template Selection button. In the Template Gallery, you can now select a template that fits your needs. The icons in the bottom of each template represent the number of media objects that the template supports, and if it's a color theme template. If you've selected a color theme template, you can apply a color theme to it. Color themes define the color of the background, footer, title, and so on. These color themes can also be customized. If you want to learn more about customizing them, be sure to check out our color theme tutorial video. On top of that, you can add transitions to each message. By adding a fade transition, or by shaping or wiping them in, your presentation will look buttery smooth. The title and body text can be adjusted by altering the font and font size. Since the content fields are rich text, you can add bullet points or numbered lists to it, as well as adding a hyperlink within the text. Select the part of the text and click the hyperlink button to fill in a URL to an external web page, document, or internet page. When your template supports a number of media objects, you will be able to add images, videos, web pages, YouTube videos, and even animated GIFs. These can be added in the Media section. To add images or videos, files can either be uploaded directly to the message server and selecting them from the library, or you can add them directly from the internet by using a URL. You can filter the images in the library by site or only the images you've uploaded yourself. In Message Server 16, it is now possible to add animated GIFs straight from Giphy. Open the GIF library by clicking on GIFs from Giphy. Now enter a search query and select any GIF you like. In the YouTube section, videos can be found by entering the title in the search bar and selecting the correct video, or by simply entering the URL. A website URL can be added to show a glimpse of a web page or dedicated web page. If supported by your selected template, a hyperlink can be added in a pre-configured hyperlink button in your message. Simply enter a URL and the button will appear automatically in your message. If your template supports a ticker, an RSS feed can be entered in the ticker field. Now that your message is completed, additional outputs and options can be added. Your message can be published to multiple outputs such as PC, TV, and mobile devices. New in Message Server 16 is the Microsoft Teams integration. This brand new feature allows you to publish your messages to your connected Microsoft Teams channels. You have the option to publish your media object and hyperlink. To make your message visible for mobile devices, you only need to switch on the app output. You then have the option to enter a different title or body text for the message that will be shown in the Netpresenter app. It's even possible to check or uncheck some options, such as likes, dislikes, and comments. To make your message more visible in the app, you can select the featured message option. Your message will now be highlighted on top of other articles. By enabling notifications, your message can be pushed out through different means. You can select an app notification, which sends out push notifications to the mobile devices. When selecting Windows notification, your message will be shown as a notification in Windows and available in the Windows Notification Center. The player pop-up will activate the Netpresenter desktop player to pop up in front of active screens to notify everyone. Should you want the message to be available during a specific time or on a specific date, you can select the start and stop time, and it's even possible to republish a message yearly. With categories, you can easily assign one or more category tags to your message. You create your own categories, for example, announcements, birthdays, and events, to conveniently organize and sort or retrieve messages in the message overview. Lastly, the default duration of a message is 20 seconds. This can also be altered in the duration settings. If you've added a video that exceeds 20 seconds, the duration will be changed accordingly. Well, there you go. You've completed creating your message. By clicking the Save button, you'll be redirected to the message overview. Your new message will be on top and switched off by default. To turn it on, simply press the status button of that specific message. As you can see, an icon has appeared next to the status button. This icon resembles the icon and the yellow text bubble around the publish button. This means your changes are yet to be applied. By pressing the publish button, your message will be published instantly. There are additional actions on your messages in the overview. You can delete a message, copy it, change its status, as well as changing the position in the overview. Editing an existing message can be done by simply clicking its title. Deleted messages will be saved in the history section. You can easily restore your deleted messages from the history section. To learn more about this history tab, you can watch our history tutorial video. Grouping messages makes it easy to change the status of multiple messages at the same time or scheduling them all together. Simply drag and drop and the group is created. Reversing this action will ungroup them. Message Server 16 has another brand new feature that allows you to show your messages on your lock screen and wallpaper. These messages need to be created in a specific site. Again, you can create a message by filling in a title and a body text, add an image to your message, and even select a template and color theme. On the right side, you will see a live preview of your message. After you saved your message, switch the status button to on, click the publish button to make your message visible instantly. To learn more about this brand new feature, be sure to check out our website. To see the impact and reach of your messages, click on the statistics icon. A pop-up with message statistics will appear. When you click on statistics in the top bar of the message server overview, a dashboard with details of your site and key statistics of all your messages will be opened. Curious about this feature? Watch our statistics tutorial video to learn more. And that's it. Don't forget to watch our other tutorial videos to master all our features. In need of some assistance? Please contact us. We're happy to help.